up on our way to Grand Canyon here, coming up the state line. There's Buffalo Bills up there. It's the people that live there that work at Buffalo Bills that cook their turkeys and hams over here.
Instantly cooked meal right there.
Right, you just take over here on these solar collectors, you bring your turkey out on a big piece of fishing string. You swing that thing, you swing that turkey up in there, and it flash cooks it. That's what's really cool.
You gotta do it quick though. You gotta.
Yeah, oh yeah. You don't want the string to melt.
Look at that.
All right, and if you look close at the lower one right there, you can see a guy throwing a ham up into that. $65 right there. So anyway, got the permit, you know. I do want to do a shout out to Casey on the South Rim.
Yeah.
The Ranger Station. We were working here from Pipe Springs to South Rim, and she did hook us up. She did take care of us. It just took a little working together, but it's all worked out. She said, you know, pretty much they don't get too many requests for permits to do what we're doing through there. So it's not surprising.
Yeah, she even down there, when I was talking to her about the route, it took me a little bit to explain what trailhead we're starting from, what loop we're doing, actually where we're going, because even the rangers aren't familiar with this area too much. This is a really remote backcountry hike we're about to embark on.
Right, so really remote. We're almost there, and anyway.
See you at the trailhead.
See you at the trailhead.
We already got two flats, one right there and one right here. Look at this.
Pretty much right in the middle of this as well. We've got a little over 25 miles to go down this way. And we've come down from Colorado City 25 miles. Two flat tires already.
We just got here. I mean, it's just amazing. Our front right tire is 90% flat right now.
Two tires, 60 miles on a dirt road. But that view is just breathtaking. I mean, it looks like a prehistoric landscape. And we're gonna be walking off into it for 6 days with no water. There's no guarantee that the springs are gonna be running. We know one spring is no good. The other spring is marginal water when it is running. And the spring that we know is good, we don't know that there's even water there. So we're walking into basically
a potential rescue situation.
Right. And we brought 6 liters each. I mean, my God, how much water can a person carry?
All right, man, we're starting the trail, Tuckup Trailhead right here. And we got a 5-night, 6-day hike, roughly about 65 miles along the Esplanade here. We're gonna hike along the Esplanade to Tuckup Canyon, then drop down 7 miles through Tuckup Canyon to the Colorado River, and then hike downstream westbound along the Colorado River to the Lava Falls Trailhead. That takes us back up and out to this trailhead that we're standing on now.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
You're scaring me, man.
Are you ready for this, buddy?
You know, just to be honest, though, I do have a few butterflies, you know, but I'm very excited. You know, this is what we do, these extreme treks. And, you know, I'm confident. I'm ready to get going. You know, after those flat tires, I'm happy to be on the trail, so. Into a dry wilderness where without water you're gonna die. So it just adds a whole nother dimension and layer
to trekking.
Yeah, I got a little bit of butterflies. This is gonna be one of our craziest hikes we've ever done. Here we go, man. Do it.
All right, let's do it.
Using your best knowledge and your best capabilities to trail find, just constantly looking for cairns and looking for footsteps on dirt and slick rock and anything just to make sure you're going the right way.
We've been losing the trail on and off all day and it's really killing the time.
We backtracked a couple of times thinking we weren't on the trail, but probably an hour and a half spent today was spent looking for the trail. The trail up here is important though because you're at on a certain elevation, on a certain ledge, with right over here a 3,000 foot drop straight down into the Colorado River. So the risk of going off trail and thinking, hey, I know where to go, is getting cliffed out.
Right, and then you're screwed.
And today we actually got cliffed out a couple of times. A
couple times. We had to backtrack. Yeah. One time we had to backtrack a half mile.
Back over here, we were over 150 feet high off of the trail. And as these terraces, the geology is, if we're a terrace low or a terrace high and we get cliffed out, that could mean half a day of backtracking.
Going in and out of these canyons all day long, there's no straight shooting anywhere. You're just weaving in and out constantly.
When you do hikes like this, you know, you got to keep in mind and leave room for this, because this definitely route finding skills involved in this, no doubt.
And John, I had a blast today, though. I mean, it was tough. I mean, I told you, I've been being honest all day.
Me too.
And everybody who knows me as well knows the miles I can do with John, without John, and John the same thing.
Right.
This thing kicked my butt.
I was pulling 24 milers last October with the PCTers in Canada. I didn't even make 8 today.
Right.
That tells you how hard this terrain is and what carrying water does to you. In your closet, in your hand, exit light, end the night, take my hand, rock the never, never land. Yeah, yeah. We're gonna camp right here tonight at somewhere between mile 7 and 8 from the trailhead, and we're turning back and we're going back tomorrow because it's just too risky. Kind of like the H2L.
Right.
Will has family, I have kids to tend to, and it's not worth getting stuck out there.
Well, again, this is a March hike. We knew it, you know, so coming into this, no, we knew this is a March hike. And you know, like preferably too after a rain so that you have water in all the little rock depressions on the slick rock, and we didn't have any of that.
We saw out of the hundreds of potholes we saw today, which people always talk about, the pothole water is really good water. We only saw one pothole with water today.
You know, so I think I admit, caught a little off guard. And again, it was the water weight. The water weight killed us, and there's still not enough.
Bottom line is, we're calling it safety reasons. Mainly the water issue and lack of being able to make miles to make sure we can get to water if we do run out.
Hey, I'm still thirsty too. I could drink the rest of my water tonight.
Me too.
And, you know, I got to save it for tomorrow. But I could drink the rest of it right now. I don't know if this will make the cut, but what we're doing by going back with the water that we have and stopping it here is what experienced hikers do. Because I'll tell you what.
Right.
Not for sure. But the odds certainly went way up today with that water in terms of going that way and either dying or being rescued, which I don't want to see you die. I don't want to die. And although I was telling John, the helicopter footage would be pretty good.
It would be pretty good footage.
There goes Johnny right there. He's alive. You know, but certainly, you know, taxpayers' money and everything. I mean, it's just reckless. We're going to head back. We're out of water. That's just the way it goes, right?
Yeah.
No water, heading back, and yeah, I don't know what trail we've been on.
This is the main reason we're heading back. That's all the water I got, this 32-ounce full bottle.
Same here, I got the same amount.
There's no water sources where we can't get water at Willow because of the warnings of really high mineral content, which gives you really bad diarrhea and, intestinal problems. So if we don't find Dome Spring tonight, which was where we were supposed to camp tonight, our second camp, we'll be totally screwed and out of water. And or say we get there and it's dry, or just, you know, all or any of the above is just too much of a risk. So we're heading back.
Yep, heading back out of here. And we got 16, 18 miles to get back with just one little bottle of water each. So it's not good. So we're going to get hitting it right now.
Is better not said. Now I'm closer to the edge. It was 1,001 and 1,000,002. Time to go down in flames, and I'm taking you closer.
And John's goal was, and it's a valid goal, is instead of going back and forth along the trail that we came on, which just kind of follows the contours of the rim, to just cut straight across and come cross country over here. I want to be honest too, I was getting a little testy because I got 27 ounces of fluid left. I was worried that we were going to get cliffed out. And it's a valid argument, but John's confidence and his route finding skills definitely paid off. I did backtrack a couple of times, and the last time I actually backtracked maybe 300 yards, John found a route up that big drainage that was totally doable. So instead of going all the way back down, which would have been a disaster, I did come up and follow John's route, and we made it.
Yeah, we came from across all that grassland instead of, right, you know, going in and out. You can see the fingers, you know, going in and out of these fingers all along there. Right. And you can even see the two track there behind Will,
right
there. I mean, it goes around that finger, but we're just kind of traversing straight across this way along the grass. And we're eventually going to drop down to the two track right over this knoll here and then take it the last 2 or 3 miles to the trailhead.
Doing this route that John navigated definitely saved us, I'd say. I'm thinking 3 miles. John has confidence. John and I both have done off-trail. But the fact of the matter is, there's no laughing matter doing this. I wouldn't suggest anybody goes cross-country with little to no water in the Grand Canyon, because you could die, easily die. And again, for me, just the fear was, we do all of that with no water and get cliffed out. But dude,
we made it.
Did not get cliffed out, baby! Oh, I'm gonna drink. We get back to that car, man. In fact, we get to that two-track, I'm drinking the rest of my fucking water. I don't care.
Because we got 5 gallons waiting for us in my truck.
Look at this sweat on me.
Yeah, look at the salt.
I mean, the salt just coming off me, man.
Yeah. Almost there. Be warned. You
know, yeah, be warned.
If you ever plan to do this hike, Tuckup Canyon, I would say watch the weather and do it right after a good rain. That way you know you have water along the way, at least for a couple days in the beginning parts. Because like I said, the unknowns is what's really killing us. Right?
Yeah, I want to come back and do this whole thing. You know, I hate getting beat, but certainly, you know, I admit right now, it kicked my ass. I fell twice. You know, we learned a lot. I learned a lot on H2L about this kind of terrain, and certainly the last 2 days up here. And so we're going to go back to Toro Weep, and you know, we'll go from there and see what's up.
Lick our wounds, and this is why this trail is not this heavily hiked right here.
Right. Hopefully at least people can watch it up to here and see a couple of idiots late in April. See what happens to them.
This just reinforces our decision not to go forward. When Will and I both got back to the truck, we had zero water left.
Yeah.
So, you know, and it's only 1 o'clock right now. So if we would have kept going and, you know, hiked a full day, we would have been out of water. And if we couldn't find a spring, or if we did find it and it was dry, we would have been totally screwed with no water. So
John said earlier that because we've done the H2L and we have carried water, we thought we could heal it. But we had a for sure source of water on the H2L, which were our water caches. We cached water.
Yeah.
So even though we were carrying at times a gallon of water each, we knew as long as we could get up that mountain and over the other side, we've got water.
We knew water was there because we put it there a week earlier.
We put it there. Yep.
So anyway, enough excuses for our pussying out. We're done, and we're going home.
Going home, gonna go get some In-N-Out burger. That's what I want.
Yep. And then when we get back to Vegas, we're gonna swing our curtain.
Turkey swing, baby.
All right.
Later.
Later.
Closer to.
If anybody knows what a choya is, I kicked one. It was great. Two spikes went through my foot, one into the webbing of my foot. I had to pull it out. It was pretty bitching. That's the highlight of the day for sure.